Yeah, so we're talking about the adoption of it, adoption of SWIFT GPI. So more than 120 plus banks already opted for the SWIFT GPI. Around 24 banks are already live with the GPI. Now 40 banks will be live by end of this year, that is year 2017. Now this brings a very good adoption rate. Okay, one of the impacted areas that now we have to focus now on is, as a bank, if I see I have certain benefits as in corporate, as in my client, they are going to receive certain benefits when I implement the SWIFT GPI. Now when I assume that as a part of this initiative, I have to make a commitment and start using it or start opting out this particular technology, what all impacted areas would be at my end? So I'll start with that. So we will have a certified payment system. So each bank is using their some vendor specific payment system, or probably payment system which is given by SWIFT. So this particular payment system has to have couple of changes in itself, or probably a should be certified by the SWIFT GPI. So one of the first point that when we talk about certification, it brings us SR 2017 compliance. Okay, SR 2017, every year SWIFT releases their standard releases of messages, or probably its format libraries, in every year. So let's say 2015, 16, 17, 18, and onwards, they keep on releasing this. Now for SWIFT GPI, they have SR 2017, which has couple of changes which is related to GPI itself. So the message types like MT103, which is corporate to corporate or bank to bank transfer message, MT199, the free format messages, which also has GPI types, GPI related changes, MT202, or the cover payments, which is still not being used by GPI, but of course in future they are expecting them to these messages to be used. Then MT096 or 097, the fin copy and the fin inform message, be it Y copy or T copy, these changes are there in the SR 2017. Usually it's a part of upgrade. Anyone who is using SWIFT has to use these kind of upgrade as a part of compliance norm. Now that is the first thing, the connector APIs. If you have seen, the bank is updating the API tracker, okay, because with the help of tracker one can understand the clear status of payments at that moment of time. Now these updates has to have some sort of connector configured in the system, so that these updates get populated, or probably by a push mechanism, that is MT199, or probably a pull mechanism with the help of APIs. So these connectors or the APIs needs to be configured in the payment system of the bank. Then the processing of the message. Now once you get the message, latest message library of SWIFT GPI, which is like SR 2017 compliance. Now to understand these messages, because MT103 now has a unique tracking number in embedded inside it, which is a part of header 3 of the header 3 block, okay, which is like 121 and the unique reference number, and 111 is a service type, which is like 001, which is specific to unique B2B payments. Now these changes has to be understood by the system, validated by the system, and then processed by the system. For this understanding, the payment system has to have these kind of changes in place. And finally, the SLA rules. As we have seen that in the observer, what is the SLA defined for each particular banks, and whether that bank itself is compliant for that particular SLA or not. So those changes has to be a part of your payment system. These changes basically are being certified by the SWIFT GPI. It means your payment system as a bank, my payment system should be certified with the help of SWIFT GPI. The second change, which would be there in the infrastructure of SWIFT, would be I would be connecting to the SWIFT using SWIFT Alliance Access, or